The Birth of Hell, written by Jack Finney. First, let me tell you the kind of story it is. Then you tell me, like, what is kind of the story? Like, what genre does it do?
Yes, children, today we have got the third level. So the story is like this. Here in the story, the narrator once goes to the Grand Central Station. This station has two levels. It has got two levels. It is confirmed. The timetable is a proof, because when you go to a station, the timetable, it depicts like where some train would come and where from where it would go, you know. So timetable is a proof that there are two levels. Right, but so there is like, it's like proof, like even the railway department, you know, they can swear that there are two levels, but narrator says that he has been to the third level also. He says that he visits third level as well. But there are two levels. How does narrator visit third level? First of all, we need to understand, like, why does narrator says that he visits third level? Why does he say this? Maybe it was first or second level. Maybe it was first or second, but he says that he went to third level. But he says that he was sure that it was third level. It was not first or second. There are many evidences to favor his argument that he went to third level. What were those evidences? Number one, he says that when he goes to that third level, there were many different things. There, whatever he saw that was totally different than what usually it is. Because it was not that he went to the station for the first time that day. It had been his, you know, routine to go to the station, because he would pick up the train, he would catch the train from there. Okay, he would come back by train from that station, from his office. He would go, he would come back. So it was his routine to go to the station. It was not something new. It was not that he did not know what kind of station it was. But on that particular day, when he lands in, you know, third level, he finds the different things. What different things were there? For example, the people there, they were dressed up differently. Their dressing sense was a proof that it was a time somewhere in 1890s. Right? Then he witnesses the lights. The lights at the station at the time, they were gas lights. If we go to a place right now, then the kind of lights which we witness all around us and the lights which were there in 1890s, they were totally different. So he witnesses that the lights were not the same as he had always seen in first or second level. The lights in 1890s might have been gas lights and they were there. That was not enough. Another thing he found that the spittoons were kept. Spittoons. They are not common nowadays. Then the third thing, the kind of trains it were. The way they looked like. That also showed that it might have been 1890s. The biggest proof came. Two big proofs were there. One was he saw a pile of newspapers there. So the newspapers depicted, it was the world. The world was not being published in his present times. And secondly, there the news was about the President Cleveland, and President Cleveland was there in 1890s. He was not a contemporary president of Narrator. Got it? One biggest proof came when he went to the ticket window and he asks for a ticket. And the ticket officer asked him the money and the kind of currency he kept. That ticket officer, you know, he looked at him very suspiciously, because he thought like this person, that is the narrator, was trying to swindle him, that is cheat him. Why did he think like this? Because narrator was giving him absolutely a different currency. In 1890s, the kind of currency it was there, that currency was totally different which he had in his times now. So when he gave him his currency, that person, ticket officer, considered him to be a cheater or swindler, and he wanted to hand him to the police. And the narrator had to run away from there, because that currency did not work in those times. Then he left that third level and came to his house. He told the story to his wife that he visited third level. The wife, you know, was quite worried. She thought like maybe her husband had got mad. She consulted the psychiatrist. They had a family psychiatrist, Sam. Okay, there is one more very important character, Sam. So his wife consulted Sam, and Sam came, and narrator told him everything about what he had seen at the third level. And Sam told him, Sam being a psychiatrist, told him that actually third level does not exist. And if you visited the third level, that is because you were seeking an escape from this world, the world of tension and stress. I'm repeating, this is very important. So this Sam, that is a psychiatrist, he told the narrator that if he visited third level, it was his, Sam said like he said, that visit to third level was an escape. That it was an escape from the world of stress psychiatrist told him. So as per psychiatrist, did this third level exist? Chitish, as per Sam, that is a psychiatrist, does the third level exist? No. So as per the psychiatrist, the third level is not there. If the narrator says that he went there, he said it was just your figment of imagination. You went there because you are so tired of this world. You are so stressed up that unconsciously you sought a refuge in the third world or the third level, the level which was of the past. That is 1894 actually it was. What time it was, where when he went to third level? It was 1894. So he traveled to the past, 1894. And he says that you went to past because right now your present is very stressed up. And your tension, stress, this kind of lifestyle makes your mind take a refuge in the past. Why in the past? Because in the past, life was not very hectic the way it is now. In the past, life was not as stressed up as it is now. Why it was not so in the past? Can you tell me? Even you might have heard your grandfathers saying that in the past, the things were far better. If not your father, grandfather, then their fathers might have been saying this. Somewhere or the other, the previous generation says this. Like in the past, the time it was not like this. The life was not that stressed up. There was some relaxation. We often hear our parents or grandparents say, like in the past, the things were cool. We also used to work, they say, that we also used to work. We also used to earn good money. We also used to have a good life. But this kind of tension, stressed life was not there. So why this big change has come? If you talk about environment, even then degradation is there. If you talk about our personal life, even then, you know, that life is you know, full of stress, worries, tension. We are always running. Not only we, those who are doing, you know, jobs, not only the students, but even those who are enjoying life, those who could have enjoyed very well at home, even they say that we are always running. There is no relaxation. So why is there no, you know, you can say cool life? Why the life is not stress-free? The reason is now it is modern life, modern time. And what makes this life modern? Because of the industrialization, because of the advent of industrialization. When industrialization had not come, when computer era had not come, then the life was quite peaceful. Because the life was not all about running and running and running. The machine, the era of machine has made our life also mechanic. So we have also become like machines. We run like machines, we work like machines. So because of such kind of mechanism, you know, mechanic era, machine era, we have also become somewhat like robots. So we have become devoid of emotions. We have become the ones who are not that good in, you know, keeping relations. So instead of giving much importance, more importance to relations, we give importance to money and matters. And that is the root of all, you can say, stress. Okay, this is what we talked about in Keeping Quiet. That poem also had the same theme. It's our, you know, single-mindedness to be after money and matters that we have lost our peace of mind. And in order to regain peace of mind, we need to do self-introspection. We need to take a break. We need to relax for some time. And that time for relaxation is not there. Even if when we are sleeping, we are not actually sleeping. We are thinking about the next time. We are thinking about the next strategy. We are thinking about the next plan. So the more we are running, the more we are lagging behind actually. The more is the urge to go back. Maybe unconsciously, maybe subconsciously. So this thing, this is what has happened with the narrator, and this is what Sam tells him, his psychiatrist. So then, you know, his friends, narrator's friends, they consider like he was the one who was seeking the refuge in the past. And even Sam says that even the hobby of collecting stamps is somewhat like taking refuge in the past. I'm telling you, explaining again. He says that even the hobby of stamp collection narrator says the narrator is also fond of collecting stamps, right? And he is told that he collects stamps, that is also because he seeks refuge in the past. Narrator says, no, here you are wrong. Narrator says that even my grandfather used to collect stamps. And my grandfather lived in a time when it was very peaceful. It was somewhat in 1890s when he lived. If at that time he was collecting stamps, despite the fact like he was living in a peaceful era, then it means that collecting stamps is not about seeking refuge in the past. He says that if I also collect stamps, then you cannot say that I am collecting stamps because I want to go to past. Because even my grandfather used to do the same thing, but his life was quite peaceful. Then why would he like to go to the past? So the narrator nullifies the proposition that collecting stamp is a hobby of the people who want to take refuge in the past. Got it? Okay. So then Sam, his psychiatrist and all, they have the view that it was his figment of his imagination. And yes, afterwards, during this time when the narrator had visited third level, there he found that he realized that if he wanted to, yes, one thing is there. Narrator now wants to go to third level actually. He really wants to go there. Why does he want to go there? Because then there was peace. Then there was solitude. Then there was beautiful environment, beautiful, you know, trees, you know. He wanted to go to Galesburg in Illinois. He wanted to go to that place in the past. But what was his shortcoming? Why was he not going there? Because, yeah, there is no actual way to go there. But he had gone there once. But, and now he is thinking, like, if by chance, if he again goes there, he will not come back. He plans like this. So accordingly, you must be remembering that at the ticket window, he had to run away from ticket window. Why? Because he did not have the currency to catch the train to past. And now he decided that whenever he would get the chance to go to the third level, he will not come back. Rather, now he was getting ready to purchase or get the currency of that time. Right now, this narrator had $300. And he went in to get its, you know, get the old currency in exchange of it. So when you want to get old currency, will you get it for the same amount? Will you have to pay more or pay less?
More.
And when you have to pay more to get the old currency, that is called premium, to give the premium amount. So he had only $300 from his savings and he was ready to pay a premium amount to get the old currency. And how much premium amount he had to give? He had to give $100 as premium amount to get old currency. So in exchange of 300, he got 200. But even then he was happy. Why? Because he knew that in 1890s, the things were far better than they were now. In 1890s, 200 would be equivalent to 1000. Because then inflation was not there. Needs were not much. Now, what people used to manage with 10,000 about 20 years ago, now that 10,000 has become equivalent to 1 lakh. It's not that value of money has gone down. The value of money has gone down because our demands have increased. About 20 or 30 years ago, not even one AC was in every home. If somebody used to have one AC in one full house, that was a big deal. Now, if there are four rooms, all four rooms should have four ACs. In those times, about 30 years ago, one TV in one house, and now each room one LED. In those times, one car would mean something very big, and now as many family members, that many cars. So why has the value of money gone down? Because demands have gone up. Now what we could manage with 10,000, now even 1 lakh is less. And then we say now the peace of mind is less. Why will peace of mind be more? When we'll have to manage four cars in a house, when we'll have to manage four ACs in a house, when we'll have to manage, you know, earlier, you know, simple people used to have a simple life. But now each family member has different air conditioners, different hair conditioners, different shampoos. In every washroom, you'll have different, you know, things. In earlier times, there used to be one or two washrooms in one house, and everybody would use the same kind of soaps or same kinds of shampoos. Now the things have become different, and those different things have brought in tensions. When we could manage with just one kind of soap, now in one house you need, if five family members are there, then five varieties would be there. If you'll bring so many things in one house, the tensions will also be multiplied. It's not about just spending money, it's also about bringing tensions. Very nicely, we would be like getting our five ACs working the whole day and night. But when the bill comes, then we crib like so much of bill. The government is not doing anything. Right? So the thing is, like, we people have changed our lifestyle. Our lifestyle has become the one which is more tension prone. not attentionless. Even if we would go to go for cycling to gym, we would go in a car. Going to for cycling in a gym, we would go in a car. And there we would do cycling. That is what the like modern life has become like. So that is the all root cause of all troubles. So narrator wants to go to past. He gets premium, he gives premium amount to give to get the old currency. And he waits for the time when he would be able to land in third level. But he's not able to get. He tries to search third level each time he goes to the central station, but he does not get the, does not get to the third level. And his wife is also tensed. And she also counsels him, like, leave it. So then he tries to forget about the third level. But one day, he, when he was like, you know, searching, when he was like, you can say, having the stamp collection, right, from the past time, which his grandfather also used to have. So he finds one letter, one cover letter. There is one mention of cover letter in the story. Cover letter is, it's the issue of the stamp on the day it is, you know, issued. If today one stamp is issued, if I am very fond of stamp collection, then what will I do? I will get that stamp affixed on an envelope and I will post it to my address. I will get an envelope. I will put that stamp on it. I will write my own address. I will post it. And what will happen? That letter will come back to me. That is called the cover letter. Why will I do this? Because on that stamp, I will be getting the stamp of the postage department. And that will become a proof of the date and all regarding the issuance of the stamp. Got it? So this narrator, you know, he found one cover letter. There were so many cover letters because his father, grandfather also used to go for stamp collection. So those people who are fond of stamp collection, they have cover letters. They don't just keep the tickets like this. Stamps, they have the cover letters. So he gets one cover letter and it was of 1894. Earlier also he had frisked through those you know, cover letters, but today it was a new letter in that. He opened it, he took it out, it was of 1894. But this was new. The kind of envelope it was new. He opened it and when he opened it, he was surprised to see that it was the cover letter. It was the you know, letter from Sam, his psychiatrist. He read it out, he opened the letter and it was written, Sam told him that he was now in 1894. He was at Illinois. He's living in 1890s. Getting? Sam, his friend, the letter showed that it was from 1894. It was a proof ki 1894 ka hai. He opened it and the letter was from his friend Sam, psychiatrist. That what was written in the letter, that it, he was from Illinois. He was at Illinois. And he was writing the letter from there. He was with his wife there. And he was telling in the letter, he explained that it was very pleasant there. The life is very beautiful. It is very calm, very cool. No tensions. And he invites narrator to come to Illinois with his wife. Right? And now the narrator had the letter of his friend, the one who did not believe that third level is there, but he was there now. With this, the story would end. And you'll have to seek the answers to many other parts. So where had Sam gone? Had Sam really gone to third level? Yes or no? Sam did not go to third level. Then how come he wrote this kind of letter? Yeah. Yes. Now the story has ended like this. Now it is all up to us how we explain it. It is all up to us. So first of all, what you people will do today, you will give the story a suitable end. You people read the story, children, all of you today, all you, on your own. read the story thoroughly. I have almost explained 90% each and everything of the story I've explained in this lecture. You read the story on your own and give this story an ending in your way. What do you think? No restriction. Whatever you think, like, you can give the story an ending from your side. Okay, and tomorrow we'll be listening. I'll be listening. We'll be discussing the ending from your point of view. Then we will discuss the text question answers. So you read the story thoroughly on your own. Is that clear? Will you do that? Will you do that, children, here? Will you do that here, online students? Okay. Yes, what about the others? Okay. So all raise hand. All, yes, those who say like you will read, then raise hand. Okay, Abhinav, well, yes, come on. So it's a very interesting story. When you will read it on your own, then you would really love it. And then you will have hundreds of the things you discuss in the class. And the discussion will be an open forum. Tomorrow I'll be unmuting you. So you will be discussing whatever you would like to. Okay. And children, today be ready for the test. And today your test is of My Mother at 66 and an elementary school classroom in a slum and Keeping Quiet. Three poems will be in the test. Okay. Anyone who has to ask anything? Charanjot? Do you want to ask anything better? Okay, if anybody wants to ask anything, you can. So prepare the poems, My Mother at 66, Keeping Quiet, and Elementary School Classroom in a Slum. They will be there in the exams this time. Okay? So prepare those poems very well for the test. The test will be posted at 2:00. And don't forget to send me the screenshot. It will take only 5 minutes for you people to do the test. But yes, prepare it thoroughly.